Hello and welcome to my show. My name is Dr. Weisenheimer. I was just enjoying an axolotl animation, a weird amphibic animal. It was rendered on a GPU. The animation of the arms was scripted by using a simple sine wave applied to the joints of the animal. The object was created by user Kali, aka Pablo Roman Andreoli. He won this year's competition with it, and it really is groundbreaking work. As a true genius, Kali shares his insights and work with the world. The script is released for the first time with a link in the description. Thanks, Kali, it is fantastic, or how Mary Poppins would say, it is super Kali-fractalistic. This object could be a historical turning point in computer graphics. Up to now, it is standard procedure to create objects out of many little triangles or polygons. When you get too close to such an object, circles are not round anymore, and textures appear blurred. Now, with this object, you can go as close as you wish. A circle will stay round, and textures will stay focused. New details become visible. The method is known as ray marching, using distance-based object definition via mathematical formulas. These formulas can be of fractal nature as well. Let's have a look at the creation process with Fragmentarium. Fragmentarium is an OpenGL shading language editor which comes with a global illumination solver. On the left you see the code, and on the right are editable parameter sliders. We start with a function of a sphere. The sphere is defined as a distance function. This function needs two parameters, a radius and a point in space. From this point in space, the Euclidean distance to zero is subtracted by the radius. This function is evaluated for every point in space. For every point within the sphere, this function returns a negative value. The sphere itself represents the points where the function returns zero value. If you want to add another sphere or object, we still have to work with one distance function. A distance function returns the closest distance to a surface for every point in space. So, when we have two objects, two distances need to be calculated, and the smaller one is returned. If the bigger one would be returned, we end up with the intersection of both objects. Inigo Quiles, one of the pioneers of real-time rendering and the creator of the Shader Toy website, uses a modified version for combining two objects smoothly. This was also used for creating parts of the axolotl image. Fragmentarium allows us to add a floor which makes the shadows visible. Next, we apply a modulus operation to the point in space. This changes values of our coordinate system. The coordinate system count 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. This leads to our sphere being duplicated. Here it is applied on the x-axis. Now we apply it to the x and the y axis. And now we apply it to all three axes at the same time. The sphere function is a simple distance function because its root can be found analytically. The return values are clear and do not need to be estimated. We know the exact distance to the surface of the sphere for any point in space. When we want to render more complex objects like fractals, the root cannot be found analytically. It has to be approximated. When you do not have a distance function or a concrete distance to a surface, you have to find the root by checking for every point of the ray whether it's above or below zero. Here we inserted the code for a 3D Sierpinski triangle. Of course, it is possible to combine simple Euclidean objects like the sphere with a fractal object, like the Sierpinski triangle. A really interesting technique. Further information about implicit surface definition and ray marching techniques can be found in the blog of the Fragmentarium creator, which is linked in the description. Now, let's take a look at the fantastic script that Pablo created. As you can see, the script is quite heavy. Nearly every aspect of the script can be edited via the parameter sliders on the right. The eyes and parts of the face are simple Euclidean objects with special colored pupils. The limbs are Euclidean objects as well, combined using the smooth min function described earlier. The head and the body are two variants of a heavily parametrized fractal that Kali Self calls Kali Set, providing many parameters to play with. The body is bent and stretched to form a natural looking tail. The mandelbulb in the front and the background texture completes the underwater scene. As mentioned earlier, nearly every parameter of this script can be modified using the sliders on the right. Here, we modify the limb joints, the left and right part is modified at the same time, and we can adjust the arms, the hand, and even the finger positions. The most fun you gain by playing with the parameters that make up the fractal for the head and the body. Supercalifractalistic. Enjoy the script. Hopefully, you will see me soon again with a detailed introduction to the famous Mandelbrot set. What? Ah, okay. We will show the Axolotl film again.
Damages amount 80% due to battle. Nanobots are currently reading your DNA in order to restore your missing body parts. Please stay quiet during the entire healing process.